life lessons for lifetime. I would like to come before you today with this series of reflections and sharing on life lessons for lifetime. I would like to take one topic every time and share with you how we can improve our life. The first thing that I would like to acknowledge in life is that this life is a beautiful gift that we can't even imagine. Our life, if you think with all its complexities, is such wonderful that you can't have a copy of yours anywhere else. I am so unique, I am so different, I am so special in every sense of the word. Not just to, you know, bluff us, but in every sense, we are so special, we are so different, we are so unique. That makes all the difference for me to live this life well. I am not like anyone. So therefore, the wise people said, stop comparing with others. And when I acknowledge that this life is a precious gift, a gift that nobody else can even think, prepare, create for us, except for the Creator God, we'll be even more grateful. And therefore, the purpose of this series for me is also to encourage to live this life gratefully, beautifully, with so much to give, because we have received in plenty. So with this brief introduction to this life lessons for lifetime, I would like to go to the first topic of our life, how to face this life. The first thing in life is love. Love is common, you say. We know everything about love, yeah. The first thing for our life is love. What is the opposite of love? You may have a list of things. I have just one. The opposite of love is unlove. I've taken this great hymn of love from first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 13. I want to read this text for you. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels, but I have not love, I am noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all the faith so as to remove mountains, but have no love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver my body to be burnt, but I have no love, I gain nothing. And now positively, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So powerful text. Why do I begin this series with this wonderful theme of love? Because I realize that without love, you are no human. Without love, there is nothing much to life to rejoice about. We are all born with love, in the normal circumstances, we are all fruits of the love of our parents. They must have been very poor. They must have been very hard for them to live their life. But they said yes to the gift of it. And that is love. And that love has been given to us. Some of us must have been brought up with hard circumstances. We can't blame them today. We are grown-ups. We need to go back and see whether we can live those hard moments and overcome them. For life is too precious to be wasted on all these negative experiences. I also realize that life is so precious that you cannot but love it and so be able to give it as well. Bible teaches us always, love is God. God loved us first. And then we are able to love others. Jesus also gives this beautiful command about, if you are not able to love yourself, you cannot love others. How to live this life there for a lifetime to come? Merely by loving. Loving yourself loving one another, God's love being always there for us. And therefore our efforts, whether it is in thinking, whether it's in reading, whether it's in studying, should be towards this. Yes, there are many words for love, there are many expressions for love. We can talk about so many kinds of love. I think I'm talking here exactly about every kind of love. Because love in its essence is not negative. Love in itself is not bad. Yes, we talk about whether it's a marital love, whether we talk about God's love, whether we talk about our filial love for each other, whether we talk about general love for one another, whatever be, love is always positive. As someone said, if you love someone, you will not hurt that person. You'll always feel for the well-being of the other. So the letter to the Corinthians says, you can have plenty of gifts, like you can talk in tongues, but if you have no love, you have nothing. You can have prophetic powers. You can even sacrifice yourself, even be burnt. But if there is no love, there is nothing. Nothing to boast about. Why? Because St. Paul realizes that love is what actually makes us humans, not anything else. It is in and through love that we are able to experience, recognize, and also realize the worth that we are. That we are human beings, created by God. Sometimes to some human beings, we need to teach love the way even the animals love. We have a God who has taught us how to love by the very self-sacrifice. Positively, St. Paul says, love is patient, love is kind. Love is not jealous. Love does not harm the other. Love is not even arrogant and rude. In all this, we sum up things saying, love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Some of the six strong characteristics of love. It is patient, it is kind, it can bear, it can believe, it can hope, and it can endure. And what's most, St. Paul says, true love never ends. I know this person, young girl who wanted to marry the boy of her life, comes and shares with me because she was confused and said that I love this boy and I want to marry him, but I'm confused. And I asked, what is the confusion? My confusion is that I have found that this boy is not honest. He is cheating. He talks lies. And I don't believe, but I don't know how to give up. I don't know how to give up on him, but I'm confused. I told her, he has simply broken the very essence of love. If so, you have to make a decision whether that love is genuine. In other words, that kind of love will end. Real love does not end. It can bear all things. It can endure. It is patient. It is kind. What's most, it can always hope without giving up. For love comes from God and it is a strong bond. Love is stronger than death, and it is true for us. Today, we realize that one of the best ways to live our life is to love. Even if we had some unloved experiences in life, even if we had experiences that were hard, this is no time to sit and worry about them, but to take the next step, to let go and give yourself in to this great gift of love. It is the magic in your life.